Talks.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mayank Agarwal. I'm Senior Product Manager with Amazon QuickSight. I've been with the team for 2 years. Welcome. Today, I'm going to walk you through a very cool new feature we just recently launched, which will let you automate and accelerate your QuickSight asset deployment. So let's get started. Here's brief agenda. We'll start with introduction. What is QuickSight? You know, why QuickSight? We'll go over, I'll have a example sample use case, which is very common across most of our customers. And then we'll jump into deployments. We have two ways to accelerate and automate your deployments. When we just launched Assets as Bundle, gonna spend most of the time on that one, and I have a working demo as well. And then if time permits, we'll go over enhanced APIs as well, which were launched November of 2022. Now, our topic or agenda today is talking about deployment of QuickSight assets. So what are QuickSight assets? At high level, QuickSight has these six assets, dashboards, which is your end user facing analytics. Then there is analysis, which is essentially the drawing board for your authors to create these dashboards. Then we have data sets, which are providing data to these analysis and dashboards. Data sources, which are your backend, your data source, where the data is stored, you manage it, and then QuickSight uses data sets to connect to that data source. Then we have themes, which are your customizable look and feel of your dashboards. And then finally, folders, which are used for organizing, for sharing at scale. You can put all these assets in folders and then share at scale. So with this, the discussion or the topic today is when you're working at such a high scale, you have tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of users, you will end up creating thousands of data sets, hundreds of dashboards, tens of folders. And then at such scale, you're not going to be in one account and doing everything and then making it production ready. You would want, in a typical setup, you will have a development account for your analysts to work on. And then once they are ready with their dashboards, you want to deploy these assets in your production account. And as scale grows, you cannot do it manually anymore. So with that said, let's talk about a sample use case. We have a fictitious any company, let's call it a financial, big financial enterprise. Now, with any global enterprise, they have presence all over the world. And in this case, this any company has a presence in North America, in the United States, and then in Europe, specifically in France. And being a financial services company, they have a strict data residency regulations, which means data in North America stays in North America, data in Europe or North Europe stays in Europe. Also, each location has its own dev environment, has its own production environment, right? So that deployment has to happen as well, right? So that's a very typical common setup for big financial enterprises. We see. Now let's talk about some deployment scenarios, right? As I was just going through the use case, in this case, deployment to production account, that's the first one. So each location has a development account and then a production account. Once the development is done, deployment has to happen to production account. Now we don't want to do that manually because that's very error prone and it takes a lot of time and resources. And then finally, backup and restore. As you can imagine, that's not okay. So let's talk about Assets as Bundle. As I was saying earlier in the presentation, this is Assets as Bundle. We just launched back end of May of 2023. Let me explain you what it is, and then we'll do a demo as well. So Assets as Bundle lets you export and import assets without having to manage deployment of these assets. So which means you can lift and shift assets from one region to another region, one account to a different account, a second account, within the same account from one folder to another folder. So it's very powerful. It lets you say, okay, here's a dashboard. I want to export this dashboard along with all its dependencies. Dependencies meaning analysis, data sets, data sources, and themes. And then I would want to deploy, or it will give you output as a file. So these are the three APIs which lets you export. So the first one, start asset bundle export job. It's an asynchronous API. It will let you start the export job. And once it's done, it will give you a .qs file. And we'll go over the format as well. Describe API lets you look at the status of any current running job. And the list API lets you look at the history. So if you have an auditing use case, you want to see who did what in last 15 days. So it will store the export jobs for last 15 days. And then once your export bundle is ready, we have import APIs for you, where you can go to another account or within same account, different region, or within same account, different folder. You can run these import APIs to import the dashboards and its dependencies you just exported. So it's literally lift and shift, like copy, make a copy of these assets without the data. So it's very critical to know that this does not export or import the underlying data. It export and imports all the definitions and all the assets, like the metadata. So import has the same set of APIs. It will start your import job. You can use the describe to look at the status. You can also look at the history of like past 15 days, which bundles were imported. And then these are the supported assets and format: analysis, dashboards, data sources, data sets. And then you have themes. And finally, the VPC connections. So those are account level VPC connections to your data sources. So those VPC connections along with the data source will also get imported and exported. Two ways. One is QuickSight QS, QuickSight file, which is essentially a zip file. You can use that and, you know, save the file locally on your machine and put that in source control wherever you want to store those files, and then do the import. Or you can use AWS CloudFormation template. Here is a rough, sequence diagram. And actually, that's the demo I will show in a bit. We're not going to go through each line here, but essentially, you have a source account and you have a target account. So if you can see my mouse, you have a source account and then there's a target account, right? Target QuickSight. So you start the export job, you describe, basically, you will loop through it and see when the job is done. Once the job is done, you'll get a pre-signed URL. And then with that URL, you can put the exported file in the target account's S3 bucket. So I think that's an important point. Today we support either you download the file locally or you can put it in the S3 bucket of any of your account. Once the file is present in S3 bucket, you start the import job on the target account. Same process. You start the import job, pull the file, give the file location, and then describe the job so that you can see when it's done. And then once it says successful, the asset is created. And as I said, I will show that in a live demo in a bit. So let's get into a demo. We'll do a working demo end to end. So we have two QuickSight accounts. Imagine one in US East one. Now I have both accounts in US East one, but imagine this one is in Europe. So this account, just to remember from 3802, this particular account has this dashboard, AAB demo dashboard. I created it for this demo purposes. If you look at this dashboard, so this is the dashboard. This exists in our US East one account, and we'll save the ID for this dashboard. Now, this is our second account. Second account has, which starts with 5511, has no such dashboard. So there is no AAB demo dashboard. So what we will do is we'll export AAB demo dashboard from our first account and and import it into this account along with all its dependencies, right? Now, running the APIs in CLI, it's not, what I've done is I've created a sample web page, which will let you actually do the export and import. In the background, it is calling those same APIs and the sample code I was showing on the slides. As I said, we have the blog post. We'll share that as well, and you can refer those that blog post for the sample code. Now, all you need to export is this dashboard ID. I've played with this, so I have this stored. But this is so just to confirm. Let's double check if this is the right dashboard ID. So if you see here, this is the. So let's copy paste this instead. And then you can give a dashboard ID a name, the job ID a name. I'll call it asset bundle demo. As I said, it's calling the same APIs in the background. I created this web page to make it more intuitive and easier. And you can do it through scripts. You can have the UI for your non-tech engineers to do this this kind of job. So once you do start export, it's gonna click the export. So check export job status. That is, it's calling the describe API in the background. It's in progress. I'm gonna just click on it a few times. So once it's done, it's gonna show me successful. There you go. So this is successfully so what has happened is the exported file has been placed in the target account's S3 bucket. Okay, now we are in the target account now, and we're gonna use the same job ID to import. So if you remember, in the target account, we do not have those that dashboard and its dependencies. So we'll start the import job here. Same process. It's an async process. So you'll have to check the status and its destination. So it's successfully created. Okay, so let's go to the target account now. It will still not appear here. So one thing to note is with export and import, the permissions do not get exported, imported. And the reason is you will not have, and by permission, I mean who the owners and viewers of these assets. And the reason is these, you will not have the same set of individuals using development account and then production account. So permissions are something which needs to be handled post import. So for that, for your administrators, we have asset management console now. So over here, we let you search, do a partial name search. And if I see, I should see all the assets with A, B, there you go. So all these assets were just imported. And then we can share these assets with, this console will let you share and transfer assets in bulk. So once I share with myself, now, if I go back to QuickSight console, I should see these, that dashboard should be listed here. Okay, there you go. So this dashboard has just appeared. So yeah, so the dashboard is here. It's that simple. We literally had four API calls, and we migrated dashboards. And if you want to see the dependencies as well, we have this data sets, which AAB demo data set, and then data source as well. So all the dependencies along with the AAB demo data source. So all the dashboards along with all its dependencies got deployed or migrated from one account to another within minutes. You don't have to create anything. You don't have to have any manual intervention. You can automate the whole process end to end. So with that, I hope this was useful. Demo is concluded, and we're looking forward to getting comments on our blog post. Please try it out and let us know if we can help out. And hopefully, this will help you speed up your asset deployments in QuickSight. So thank you so much. Looking forward to hearing your feedback, and please try it out.